Former Trump cabinet member Betsy DeVos, the former Secretary of Education, she spoke out today about January 6th, and she talked about on that day maybe invoking the 25th Amendment, the cabinet votes to remove a president because he's not well one way or another, in an interview with USA Today. Take a listen.
I felt that there were things that the president could have done to stop the activity, to turn it back, to avoid all of the things that ensued, and it was just a bridge too far. I had conversations with a number of my colleagues, and then importantly, I also spoke with the vice president, and he made clear to me that that was not a direction that he was going to move in.
This is the first time we have heard from a member of the cabinet at that time
Correct.
About it possibly invoking the 25th Amendment, even though they ultimately didn't do it.
Correct. We've heard this on background, but this is the first time we are hearing on the record a member of the cabinet confirming that these discussions went on.
And again, a super Trump supporter,
Right.
a very conservative Republican. I mean, her bona fides in the MAGA movement until today probably. Are unquestioned.
Correct. And she also said something in the interview that will be key to the committee. She said, when I saw what was happening on January 6th and didn't see the president step in and do what he could have done to turn it back or slow it down, it was obvious to me I couldn't continue, and she resigns. Again, the committee is focused on not only what Donald Trump did leading up to January 6th, but what he didn't
do. He didn't stop it.
Correct.
It's not just Trump, of course. We're getting new audio recordings of others, including House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy in the days after the January 6th attack. This is new. Let's take a listen.
We cannot just sweep this under the rug. We need to know why it happened, who did it, and people need to be held accountable for it. And I'm committed to make sure that happens.
Right now, he's really only committed to sweeping it under the rug. After this tape came out, Eric Erickson, again, very conservative, a radio host, he tweeted, Kevin McCarthy wanted to investigate January 6th before he didn't. The man has no principle or spine, and the GOP should not trust him with further leadership. What do you think?
They shouldn't, and he's been cowed. And the fact of the matter is, any normal reaction for that from that day, what, 187 minutes when President Trump did absolutely nothing to tell these people to go home was shocking. And that's why people were talking about the 25th Amendment that day, even though they'd been previously talked about it basically from the beginning of the administration. They were talking about it that day because he was really, you know, he's there watching television apparently and gleefully. He wanted this to happen. And the irony about that, about, you know, Mike Pence did the right thing on January 6th insofar as he followed his constitutional duty when it came to the electoral vote count, but he should have. He should have stood up under the 25th Amendment, and they should have found Trump unfit for office. In fact, it would have been the easiest way to protect the country at that point of time, because the way that Section 4 of the 25th Amendment works is that if the cabinet and the vice president certified the president's unfit, the president can contest that, but the vice president is acting president until Congress acts, and Congress had 21 days to act.
Yeah.
And it would have run out the clock on the administration, and we wouldn't have had the problem of a madman still with the control of nuclear weapons in the White House.